Hey, I'm Ryan Reynolds.
Recently, I asked Mint Mobile's legal team if big wireless companies are allowed to raise prices due to inflation. They said yes. And then when I asked if raising prices technically violates those onerous two-year contracts, they said, what the f*** are you talking about, you insane Hollywood ass f- So to recap, we're cutting the price of Mint Unlimited from $30 a month to just $15 a month.
Give it a try at mintmobile.com/switch.
$45 up front for 3 months plus taxes and fees. Promo rate for new customers for limited time. Unlimited more than 40 gigabytes per month. Slows full terms at mintmobile.com.
So we're doing top five bingos. So are we prepared?
Yeah, that's what you wanted. Your first comment on Wax.
Number one, Zach. That could mean anything. That could mean our top five slurs. Like, it could mean anything, you know?
No. Way to clean it up there.
I like the idea that every week is a top five bingos.
I mean, half of them could have been. Well, wait.
You just changed the bingo
from the episode that's coming out next week
to 0% movies now.
What's the timeline? What comes out this week?
This is going to come out like right away.
Yeah, right. So the Hard Rain comes out this week.
And then Hard Rain.
Yeah. And then.
Yeah. Burn Notice.
What? And then Burn Notice. And then we did a whole season of Burn Notice. I've never seen that show. I have no idea what it's about.
I think it has to do with like fires.
No. All right, so there's number three on the bingo list it, right there.
No.
Is it not? Is it not like a fire department drama?
No.
A fire department drama?
Absolutely not.
I think you're thinking of Chicago Fire.
Some shit like that. You know, Burn. Montgomery Burns.
It's about Montgomery Burns.
What movie was he in?
Burn Notice?
We did. Was that Spencer Confidential? He's got the dog. He's the cop with the dog.
No. That's Honest Thief, you dickhead.
Oh, my God.
How could you forget that?
You know why.
That's a good movie. I've seen that movie so many times.
So, yeah. Honest Thief, where he's got the divorce and the dog. That's the Burn Notice guy. I mean, and he just runs around in a suit. And I've seen a clip where he blows up a boat.
Fire. Okay. Now, I mean, maybe... Is right.
So maybe splitting the difference there.
Yeah.
I believe he's a criminal.
I told you guys, there's some fire in there.
Told us.
He's definitely not in the fire department.
I told you.
You just need an episode where one fire happens. You're like, see? Burn Notice.
This idea is just straight up bad. That algorithm is busted. It's among the worst ideas I've ever heard.
Top five, easy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Welcome to Cinephobe Top 5, aka CT5. This is the podcast where we go straight narcissists on all of this.
Yeah.
Stare at ourselves in our reflection in the river and then fall in and drown. Drown in an avalanche of bingos and weapons and vehicles and all the different top fives from inside the Cinephobe universe. Different categories, different rankings, same Cinephobe flavor.
Let's all name one we want to do. Let's all name a CT5 we want to do.
That doesn't necessarily mean it's going to get done, right?
Right. But just because I do like the idea of top five golden dumpsters that somebody else picked.
Yeah.
So not ones that you've picked. I like that idea.
I like that one.
That's a good one.
I'm going through your guys' top golden dumpsters and saying which ones I like the most.
Yeah, you can't pick your own.
It is and it isn't. I don't know if you guys do this, but this isn't a rarity for me where there's a lot of different golden dumpsters from a movie and then one of you guys will pick one that I really like. So then in order to spread the wealth, I go with something different. Like, sure. It's very rare where it's like, I feel so strong, like, I don't care if Zach picked this. I got to pick it as well. Did Simon Says come out yet?
Yep.
Okay. Simon Says is a good example of that, right? Where it's like, you had the sex scene with the rig on the bed. You had the car floating. And Dennis, I was like, that's my house. You had Dennis Rodman sliding down the pole. And
oh, my God. Oh, my God. D-Rod.
For all D-Rod fans.
All those D-Rod fans.
What a great show. What a great episode, watch. Man.
Yeah, man. Look, I picked a fucking horrible movie, but what a great episode.
Like, there's something to be said about that. There's something
to be said. Well, it inspired this very list, which is 0% movies.
That's true, yeah.
That's why we're here, is because of Simon Says. So we'll see where Simon Says goes.
But we're talking about like 0% movies, not 0% movie episodes, right? It's not our favorite episodes.
No, it's the movie itself.
It's the movie.
Okay.
See, there's a lot that's unclear about how we're doing this one.
Oh my God. Oh, hold on. I've got to read this transcript.
A good list.
I have to read this transcript. I must read this transcript.
That's fine. It's unclear to people. Well, oh, no. That what we're doing God. Exactly.
Okay, here it is. And we said we're doing top five and bottom five. What? Zach, 0% movies. Me. That's right. Zach, essentially ranking 12-1. Maze. Okay, works. If you have them ranked 12-1, we can figure out the rest. OLIs, Zach. OLIs are 7-6. I'm confused, but we'll figure it out on the pod. Me. Yup. 12-8 are the worst five. 7 is the worst OLI. 5-1 are the best five. 6 is the best OLI.
See, Maze. No one.
Yes, 6 and 7, sense. The middle.
Cold Zach, middle, then.
Zach, the agreed. It's unclear. We'll figure it out on the pod. The only thing
we know for sure is that we don't know shit.
Yeah.
Me, how is that unclear? Zach, we don't really know what's outside looking in of who, what, whom, whomst. Me, 6 is outside looking in at top 5. 7 is outside looking in at worst 5. Zach, tough to say.
It is tough to say.
No, it's not tough to say at all. Zach, 6 might feel like 7. 7 might feel like 6 on some list. Me, it's your list.
Maze, this is why we can't have nice things.
Me, this is why we can't have things at all. Maze, Amin explains it succinctly. Zach remains unsure. Zach, I still don't know what the golden dumpster is.
I don't. Is it the best moment? Is it the worst moment? It's most memorable. I've just kind of been
stay out of it.
I've been kind of just like, you know, just lying in the weeds when it comes to the golden dumpster. Like, I don't really know what to pick. I don't know what the point of that is.
And then it devolves into something. Zach just went to the bathroom with the mics on and we heard everything in incredibly descriptive detail.
Yo, I fucking killed that nap though. Zach. Oh my God. This little bitch just buzzing around the toilet. Nailed it.
I was trying to hit a gnat buzzing around the water. Got the bastard.
I did. He
drowned in a stream of white hot urine. Zach, looks like he had the wrong natitude. Me. You zapped him out of the air. You're a natural. So,
yep.
Here we are.
Glimpse into the Cinephobe group chat.
Same exact
dynamic. So, this one's a little different in that we have two top five lists in one episode.
Yep. Two top five lists, one episode. Mega episode? Yeah. Essentially, power ranking the 0% movies 1 through 12. But right. It breaks down conveniently into two top five lists. But let me ask you guys. Which was the tougher list to make?
The worst.
Good 0% or the worst 0%?
The bad 0% is damn near impossible.
I agree with that.
Good ones, because you know which ones you like. Mm-hmm. The ones you hate, sure you don't know which ones you hate the most.
Yeah. No, I actually figuring out which one was the one I hate the most was easy. Everything after that was tough.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't sure about which one I hated the most, but differentiating 2 through 5.
Oh. Which one is worse between 3 and 4?
Thing, that's 9 through 12, or is that 11 through 8?
Yeah.
See?
CT5.
Unclear.
I mean, you just explained it. Seems pretty clear.
I want to remind everybody. Hey, sign up for that Patreon, patreon.com/countthedings. You get all access to the Discord and to our re-Washington events, old and new.
Takers next Monday.
Oh, nice.
A week from today.
A week from today.
Timeline's messed up.
Takers. Well, it's not. This is a clean timeline.
Nah. We've recorded some stuff. We haven't recorded other things. It's tough to say.
Set it straight out. Takers next Monday. Sign up for the Patreon. Join us for the rewatchington.
The 19th?
We're Takers.
Juneteenth? We're doing Takers?
Oh, boy.
Sorry, I mean.
What do you mind does it before?
You also got the ad-free episodes on there. If you want to listen to this episode ad-free. Yeah. If you want to listen to Simon Says ad-free. If you want to listen to Hard Rain on Thursday ad-free.
We're still taking quotes on what it takes for the non-supercharged episodes. I'm not promising it. I just want bids. It's gotta be a lot.
Like, I saw some people at Discord going, I'd go from $8 to $12, buddy.
Like, you're out of your fucking mind.
Thousands a month.
Yeah.
Because we're going to lose jobs.
I don't know about thousands a month, but I know that it's not $12, you fucking bingos.
We're gonna lose jobs.
Okay. Steve Jobs?
Already lost him. See what happened?
We already lost him. Yeah.
Yep. Had you paid $1,000 a month, maybe he'd still be alive.
Yeah.
R.I.P.
R.I.P. indeed.
So since we all agree that the worst 0% movies is tougher, should we save that for second?
Oh, that's really going to fuck up the timeline of this podcast.
Should we do the top 5 0% first?
So we're doing...
We're going the good ones first.
Okay.
Let's go right down the line. Let's go Zach, Amin, Maze.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
All right. OLI, American Ninja.
Wow. Impossible. There's no such thing.
There's no such thing.
Really hard to keep it out of the top five, but I think the main reason is that a lot of what I thought we were going to watch in American Ninja happens in American Ninja 2.
I thought for sure you would have been all over this.
What do you mean? Like having that in the top five?
Yeah, yeah.
I thought that was one of your favorites. Top five, man. I don't know what to tell you. But the fact that it's not American Ninja 2... It hurts it a little bit. Mm. Amin, what's your OLI?
Poison Rose.
What?
Poison Rose is on the outside looking in for me.
Wow.
Here's why. I'm going to tell you what. If we hadn't done the rewatchington, it might have been higher. But the rewatchington reminded me it is a movie that is eminently quotable that's also just full of shit. Like long periods of shit.
No.
But it has its moments are fucking fire, but there's a lot you got to go through in order to get to those moments.
That's upsetting.
My OLI is going to upset you even more, Zach. It's Theodore Rex.
OLI, the top five?
OLI for the top five movies. This was the hardest spot because I filed five of them. So I had to choose a phobe. And... we've done a rewatchington on it.
That was the one you said, number six out of 12.
We reference it all the time.
Not for good reasons.
Intensely memorable. Yeah.
Zach, is this plot lift off?
Cookies. This is plot lift off indeed.
Clip it, mates. I know you're not supposed to clip it.
3, 2, 1. You know what? That gets me every fucking time now. Every time. And I love that it's multiple times. And like, Maze doesn't, he's not like stingy with it, right? Wherever we have plot liftoff, he'll throw that shit in there and it gets me every single time.
It's a maximum of 3 of them an episode. So like, it's not that many. But also, whenever I hear it, I swear to God, whatever I'm doing, I just stick out my arms.
You start going jet? You start going like,
In my mind, I'm like, well, here we go.
All right. Number 5. We got an award out of this one. And I rewatched part of it recently. And it was way more rewatchable than I thought. We should do it on a rewatchington. Number 5, Deadfall. Deadfall. Deadfall, surprisingly...
Can we rewatch just the cage part? Can we just start and end
absolutely.
With just that?
Absolutely.
Like, tiny little rewatchington?
Where he gets fried?
Everyone else? Or was Deadfall the one with Atlantic City, the boxer?
No, that's Snake Eyes.
Snake Eyes.
Oh, shit. What's Deadfall? Which one is Deadfall?
Michael Biehn.
Michael Biehn.
Mom!
He got the car, the job with the... Or the little exchange at the car and everything.
There's a farmer's market.
Farmer's market?
Yeah.
Deadfall, number 5.
All right. My number 5. I know this is not going to be your fives, either of you, because I was the only one to file it. But guess what? I loved this movie when I was a kid. I love it today. Problem Child, man. That movie makes you laugh,
love
man.
That movie.
You I love that movie. I love it. I love it. Bucket Michael Rich is throwing the weights and shit.
Literally the only thing I remember from the movie.
No, you remember the birthday party he ruined. Right? It's my party. And
I remember a lot of montages of him doing terrible pranks.
Him just being a shit.
Also,
no, I hate it.
There was like a big grocery store.
It's the episode that established one of the longest running bits in Cinephobe history.
What's that?
Maze is a pedophile.
Oh yeah, because he was like, look how good this ginger looks or something. I can't remember what it was.
That's not a ginger. This is a ginger, is he?
I've got a whole file. Here, just scroll past the screenshots of cigars.
I
got them in there.
I do have hair like that, so that's not a bad joke, Zach. I did get caught under a truck the other day because it was parked on the sidewalk.
Maze, what's your number five?
My number five is Ballistic X versus Sever.
What? That movie sucked.
It's not good, but I remember
there are only three chaos. Things I remember from it.
Chaos had some moments. I remember some action moments.
Who's Chaos?
He's the director. He's from Tom Holland.
That's right.
There's the cars corkscrewing up in the air in harmony. There's a lot. There's like the whole shootout at the mall, which gets out of control.
Don't they go to an aquarium?
They go to an aquarium.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Without kids.
Because her son is missing.
Oh, right. She thought
so she's despondent. So she goes to the aquarium. We've also got the nanotech technology that Amin picked and weapons.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
One of the best weapons.
Blood bomb.
Nanobots. You just blow up someone's blood. But there was a lot of problems. So yeah, five, Ballistic.
All right. Number four. I actually can't believe it's this low, but just how it shook out. Gotti.
Gotti
is.
You had three better movies than Gotti.
Three better than Gotti. The movie sucks. Travolta's amazing in Gotti. He's absolutely amazing in Gotti. And the fact that I watched it the first time using MoviePass, like that's a sentimental thing to me. MoviePass recently sent me an email saying, hey, we're coming back.
We're back? And,
well, they said they're coming back, not that they're back. So I don't know if it actually happened, but that could also be a scam. But yeah, Gotti's number four.
My number four is Ballistic X versus Sever. Look, man. First of all, Lucy Liu, file. Second of all, I can't believe Bates didn't even mention one of the most famous scenes in Cinephobe history. Oh my God.
That's the third thing I remember from that movie. One is the aquarium, baby. Two is blood bomb.
Yeah.
My nose.
Was it Miguel Ferrer? Not Miguel Ferrer. Who's the chief at the beginning, who's always a chief, but usually has a mustache and didn't have a mustache this time. It threw me off. It was one of the original movies that made me want to make a podcast about bad movies because I saw it had 0% and I said, whoa, how many movies in Rotten Tomatoes history have 0%? And a lot more. I remember, this is like now maybe 6 or 7 years ago. I remember looking at the Wikipedia page and there weren't that many. Yeah. It was like, you know what it's like, Zach? It was like teams that have come back from a 3-1 deficit. You could like name all of them.
Yeah.
But like not now. There's too many. But Ballistic X versus Sever, salute to you, as Juju Gotti likes to say.
That was also one of the first ones that we had to
alternate means.
Yeah, get off of the dark web.
And I missed that.
I vaguely remember.
No, I don't.
How bad the green screen was driving across this bridge at one point with sunset. I think we've been eclipsed with green screen moments, but.
There was a shootout. I remember there was a shootout like in downtown Vancouver or whatever.
Shit ton of guns.
I don't remember that either.
My number four is Deadfall. Yes. The only thing that comes out of this is the Nicolas Cage performance, but that's still better than
Michael Biehn.
All on Ballistic X versus Sever.
Michael Biehn was so bad at narration that we named a fucking award after him.
You know? That's not why. It wasn't the narration that won him the award. It was
him crying in his underwear
with no tears and no like.
That's a good signs movie, man. That's a good movie. He couldn't even ruin that. All right, number three. I'm shocked this one is this low, but had to. Low Down Dirty Shame.
What?
Yeah, number three. I love it. Whoa. It's good. I remember watching in the theater and being in love with Jada Pinkett. I remember loving Keenan Ivory Wayans. I remember being all about this movie. Hadn't seen it in so long. Still held up. Still funny. Obviously, Charles S. Dutton is incredible in that movie. But that's number three for me.
Number three, Gotti. I remember loving this. We got to do a rewatch of Brigatti. I remember loving this movie. I remember Maze not liking it and me and Zach being stunned. Like, how could you not like this? I remember the addendum episode that we had with the guy that worked on the movie with all the behind the scenes stuff.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Remember, like, they ran out of money, so they just started selling roles to people.
And then I saw E at Dantana's not that long ago, and you guys wouldn't let it be a repeat offender.
Yeah.
The director because you saw him. Yeah, he was right at the bar. He was sitting. He was eating at the bar.
So does Forrest Whitaker at
repeat offender?
Finals? Yeah, absolutely. All right.
Chris Tucker.
Still not sure.
Chris Tucker. Yeah.
Yeah.
Repeat offender.
My number three is also going to be a low-down dirty shame.
Wow.
It's a good movie. Wow. It was fun.
It's really enjoyed good, it. But we have two that are just a little bit better, in my opinion.
All right, let's hear them. What's your two?
Number two, Johnny B. Good.
That's
what an absolute tour de force that was. Two. Went in with super low expectations, thinking this is going to be absolute shit. 8:14, this movie shit, or whatever the hell the time is in the quote.
10:48.
This movie 10:48. Is shit. Shit, bro.
Robert Downey Jr., just one of the most confusing performances we've ever seen.
Not confusing at all.
Yeah.
Okay. Not confused.
Exactly. Anthony Michael Hall
was
great
at breakfast.
Tough to say.
There's that weird scene with, like, the wife in the middle of the football stadium. There's the little person with the sombrero,
with the mixer on his head.
Yeah.
The mixer.
There's the football player who's working, like, the Quickie Mart now.
Yep.
Like, what an incredible. I would love to do a rewatching of that too. Wait, Jennifer Tilly's in that movie?
Yep.
Right? Yeah. Oh,
she's
my God.
The coach's wife or something
like
that?
Yeah, that's right. Oh, my God. And that's when we
that's when we realized that Jennifer Tilly, she'd been at it for a while and still killing. Still out here making it work. My number two, Low Down Dirty Shame. This movie and my number
one off? Just one off and you're like.
But here's the thing. My top two movies are movies that genuinely staggers me that there's 0%. Like every other movie on this list, even the ones, you know, like Gotti, whatever, like, I get it. Like, I get why people wouldn't like it, why critics wouldn't like it. I get how it's a 0%. I watched Low Down Dirty Shame. The first time I watched it, the millionth time I watched it, I'm like, how? How is it nobody likes this?
It's shocking that not a single critic.
I mean, it's not a great movie. I don't give you all. It's not Schindler's List or whatever, but there's the callback, right? But like, it's just, it's not, it's like, it's got a decent story. It's got decent action. It's funny, you know?
Problematic at times. Guys, what? March 2022, Mal Vincent gave Low Down Dirty Shame a positive review.
Finally. Wow.
It's now a 4% movie.
Oh, wow.
About time. Maybe that's it, man. Maybe it was just not enough of reviews.
Where's Michael Dukina? What? He couldn't put a fucking...
That's right, man.
Come on.
You let us down,
come
brother.
Come on.
Zach, tell him you let us down.
You let us down.
Brother.
Number two for me is also Johnny B. Good.
Yeah.
Everything Zach said. We also got a shout out. We're new in town, and we've never had this before.
That's right.
Which is a great bit that we don't go to a ton lately, but it still comes up every once in a while.
It's still good, though, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's
and
right.
The
it
fact
was
that
like
that was
like
all,
rape charges or something
that
like that?
Was
like,
all
that's what they were trying to get
him operation,
on?
And then they get thrown in jail.
Oh, man,
and then at the
weird.
End, it turns out to be a big anti-NCAA conspiracy movie.
Right, yeah.
Brian Bosworth is shooting a commercial in the middle of it
Adidas?
For some reason.
Was it Adidas commercial?
He's naked.
I think so, yeah.
There's a lot happening in that movie, for sure. It's an enjoyable time.
And also, one other note, the American Ninja's sidekick, Steve James, in that movie is a coach.
That's right.
Yeah?
Right. Mr. 0%, as he's known on CFO.
Yeah. That is what he's known as.
Until he breaks that streak.
Now I got to find another one. That's a daisy chain for you. Try to get Steve James only in a 0%.
All right. My number one 0% movie. My name's Carson Phillips and I'm a P.I. Man, that's such a... Poison Rose is such a good movie. Brendan Fraser alone. Academy Award winner Brendan Fraser alone.
Hello.
Makes that movie. You don't even have to include Travolta's incredible part in it. Morgan Freeman, like whatever happened with Famke Janssen. Like, you don't have to include any of that shit. El Travolta, who I started following on Instagram because of that movie, and she's got a weird fucking account. Like, everything about that movie, other than the last 20 minutes. The last 20 minutes are not great, but
it's a long movie, bro.
It feels long for sure because there's so much rich descriptive detail of what's happening because it's a film noir. I fucking legitimately love that movie.
There you go.
My number one, Johnny B. Goode.
Wow.
Like I said, man, like this movie, I'm staggered. Like the only thing I can think of is that every movie critic in the 1980s was a staunch believer in amateurism in the NCAA, and they just didn't want to be confronted with this thing that shattered their notions, their antebellum notions about what college sports is all about. This movie was incredibly brave and prophetic, and I thought like Anthony Michael Hall did a great job.
Yeah, he's good.
I thought outside
of the football scenes.
Doesn't he gets a call in the locker room?
Yeah, from Howard Cosell.
From an ancient Howard Cosell.
Yeah.
Who's holding the phone like this.
No. Shit. We don't need that. We don't need that.
I'm just saying. Is this on video?
Tough to say.
Man. Like you guys, I went in thinking, oh, this is 0% movie, like from the 80s. How cheesy is this going to be? And I was blown away by how entertaining it was. The montages of him playing the drums and watching like NFL games.
Like watching highlight rooms. Yeah. Wait. So how much? So since we've all picked it now, how much of this was influenced by we thought it was going to be really bad, and then it was super entertaining? Because I do know like that is an influence for me, but I also legitimately like the movie.
I look. It's hard to separate. Like Low Down Dirty Shame. Low Down Dirty Shame. I didn't know it was a 0% movie until we did the podcast, because I'd seen it before and I was like, this is great. Johnny B. Goode, I'd heard of, didn't know much about. If you had told me before, oh, this is a 42% movie, I would be like, okay. So like, I didn't know.
Didn't Roy inform us that it was Uma Thurman's first role and he just knew that off the top of his head?
Yeah. Yep.
Roy's amazing.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, I would say that predisposed 0% expectation was there for every single one except for Low Down Dirty Shame. And I remember Ballistic, I was like, this is better than a 0% movie. But Johnny B. Goode, yeah, I think that exceeded expectations like, close to the most.
Think about this. Like, Good Luck Chuck got more positive ratings than Johnny B. Goode. That's ridiculous.
And a Low Down Dirty Shame. That's fucking racism right there.
Like these movies or Jack and Jill or Grown Ups 2, like all these, those were not
the Sandler movie that we've done.
Hey, but pretty much like these were actual stories and in particular, like Low Down Dirty Shame, I guess you could accuse it of being unoriginal. It's unoriginal, but it's not like terribly done. Johnny B. Goode was like, yo man, that's like,
it's an original story. Yeah.
Original story told at a time when no one was telling those kind of stories. Mm-hmm. Like now it feels like, yeah, of course we know all that shit. But like they were doing it. This is pre Blue Chips, pre the program.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the program file.
My number one 0% movie, Impossible. An American Ninja. There is no
That's
thing.
Your number one.
It's the number one.
You got the dude like teleporting or some shit.
Colonel Thickcock.
You got the Black Star Ninja and all of his gadgets and gizmos. People were upset that we left alone. His
should have been 5%.
Flamethrower wrist rocket.
No. I mean, don't.
From
no,
the weapons.
No, don't do it.
Colonel Thickcock and his clenched cheeks. Right at eye level.
You bingo.
You've got the dude Ortega, who's the boss. Oh my God.
How are you doing this?
The hands gently against the wall is the next part of that. The dude named Ortega, who's the big boss, but he has clearly a French accent. They're in the Philippines somewhere. Dudikoff just looked like a sweaty.
He didn't talk for like 40 minutes.
Dennis.
Yeah. Dennis, when he was fasting to to look thinner on camera.
Steve James's name was Curtis Jackson. There's just a lot of great moments. Him over the wall with the motorcycle.
Oh, God. That stunt was so poorly done.
The
big fight
at the end. I think that movie was helped by being a fairly low-budget 80s action movie.
The montage of them beating up ninjas, but it's just guys falling to the ground. Yeah. It's not any actual action.
Just jump and we'll catch it right here. Editing will catch it.
I've never seen American Ninja 2, so I didn't have the same problem as Zach.
So good.
That's a future cinephobe for another day. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that just climbed the ranks for me because it was a fun time.
Yeah, that's a good one. Okay, so for the worst.
I mean, phobed it, Zach.
Yeah, I just didn't like it.
So we'll,
because we'll Steve clearly James get is to not that the American Ninja.
No, Steve James is American Ninja, but you know.
Listener, what's up? Zach Harper coming to you live from just making my picks on Prize Picks, the largest daily fantasy sports platform in North America. For my money and your money, the easiest and most exciting way to play DFS. Again, that's daily fantasy sports. It's just you against the numbers instead of battling thousands of players, including like pros and sharks, those people that really try to game the system and screw you over. You just pick more or less on 2 to 6 player stat projections and watch the winnings roll in. Basketball's here, right? So check this out. This is the cool thing that I love from PrizePicks. You can now pick combo projections across football and basketball from the Specials League, a league created specifically for combo projections that includes 2 or more players from different sports and leagues. So if you want to do like more Patrick Mahomes yards and less James Harden points, you can do that. You can do that combination. You can do any combination that they have on there. You just go to the Specials League. You want to play alongside people? Maybe you don't want to go it alone. Maybe you want to play alongside people. You can go to, I don't know, Meek Mill, Andrew Schultz. You find them in the community plays under the promos tab of the app to view entries from some of the biggest names in the Prize Picks community each week. And best of all, Prize Picks even offers a reboot policy so your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets injured. For football and basketball games, if you have the player who exits the game in the first half and does not return the second, that player is rebooted. Prize Picks, the only daily fantasy sports platform with an injury insurance policy. So I'll tell you what you do. You go to prizepicks.com/ding. And use the promo code DING, D-I-N-G, for a first deposit match up to $100. Let me say that again for you. You go to prizepicks.com/DING. You use the code DING, D-I-N-G, for a first deposit match up to $100 from our friends at Prize Picks. Prize Picks, daily fantasy sports made easy.
Now we're going OLI.
So 7 is OLI?
Yeah, so now you're working your way down.
So we're going 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Yeah, and 12, the last one you said is the worst.
Okay. Yep. All right. Okay. Number 7, OLI, Ballistic, Expert Sever.
No, man.
It's just not a good movie, but it's like I did not enjoy it the way you guys did, other than the, oh, my nose. Like that part is historic. It is forever. It is enduring.
It's but funny.
I didn't like that movie.
I would think that this is right up your alley, man. Like this kind of movie.
Too bad in a way that wasn't that fun for me.
I have to say.
I enjoyed doing the episode. Oh, he's going to put his ass against the wall again, or I don't know where he went, but yeah.
Come on, baby. Is that what it means doing right now?
Yeah, I think that's what he's doing. He's going to go get punched in the nose. It is the fact also that that's off camera, right?
No, I think that was the original, like, disembodied voices.
No, I think that was Hot Rod. Wasn't it the ambulance guys in Hot Rod? Well, I guess I don't know which one was first.
I think Ballistic was first, wasn't it?
Maybe. I can't remember.
Cinephobe.
Hot Rod was the first, like, 8 episodes we did.
Really?
Yeah.
But yeah, Ballistic, that is my OLI for worst bottom 5.
Yeah, I guess so.
0% movies.
For me, American Ninja.
Impossible. Impossible.
Again, one of those movies where it's like, it's ironic. American Ninja, Poison Rose for me were right there, the 6 or the 7 seed. Who was going to be which?
1-6 is another 7. 1-7 is another 6. American Ninja is my 6.
But it's my list. American Ninja is my 7 because again, it had quotables. I don't think the characters themselves were as memorable, right? Other than Colonel Thicott.
Well, because one of them didn't talk. The main one didn't talk.
Also, I remember the
it couldn't talk, by the way, either. Like, that was a strategic moment.
I remember the love interest was also annoying as fuck in that movie. She was just complaining the whole time.
It was also so weird for Amin to have a problem with one of the women characters, you know?
I know. Like, that was for sure a departure.
Was that Thicock's daughter?
Mm-hmm.
It was.
Thick vagina.
All right, my OLI for worst 0% movies, The Poison Rose.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
How?
Hey, Mace, how about that? Look at this. Who would have thought?
What?
Flipping it up.
But it's the number one 0% movie.
According to some, it is the number
one 0%.
Zach had American Ninja 6. I had American Ninja 7. Maze had American Ninja 1. Maze had Poison Rose 7. I had Poison Rose 6. Zach had Poison Rose 1. How about that?
And Johnny Be Good 1 and 2 across the board. But Poison Rose, if we hadn't done the rewatchington, I think Amin said he dropped it because of the rewatchington. I actually raised it up. If we hadn't done the rewatchington as recently as we did, which was within a year of doing the movie, because Zach would not stop saying Poison Rose rewatchington, gotta do it.
One of the highest rated ones we've done.
ratings for that.
I thought you were gonna say Zach wouldn't stop saying I'm Carson Phillips, and I'm like, yeah.
We all said that, all right. So that's, you know, in terms of voiceover, third person
scoring
exposition right off the bat, that's up there. It's a classic Lewis Pinnock voice. He's got that moment where he's holding the cigarette and the gun and the bow tie and the hat.
Jump off the roof.
The jump off the roof.
Fucking nothing. Oh my god. But we thought he was going into the tree. He just hit the fucking ground. Like, aim for the bushes and the other guys. Come on, man.
It still sucks though, but it's not as bad as other 0% movies on this list.
Mm. Okay.
Zach, number five, or I guess number eight.
Yeah, number five, bottom five 0% movies. Staying Alive.
Same note too, bro.
Really? We both have it as 8. The reason it is higher than the other ones is simply look out for number 1. You guessed it is the only reason
that soundtrack.
The soundtrack is a banger.
It's not just that song. There's
the whole thing.
That one, like, the soundtrack throttled that shit.
Yeah.
You know what, man? I'm going to have to re.
Wow, you're redoing the list? Making a push. Moving up?
You know what? Yes, move it up. American Ninja, drop it down.
What?
It's above American Ninja. I can do anything.
Live. What?
Yes.
It's not live.
It's live right now. It's live to me.
Yeah.
Still live to me, David.
Always the case. All right.
I don't
remember anything else from the movie, though. Like, I remember... the
chorus line and the dude, the really misogynistic gay dance instructor or whatever.
I don't remember that at all.
I think you're talking about Showgirls, I mean.
Oh, shit, am I?
Oh, file. That's
Thrust It, that guy?
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Showgirls.
Yeah, that's Showgirls.
I mean, it's a really sweaty John Travolta the whole time. That's about all that goes down in that. My number five... I'm chalking this up to recency bias, but it's Simon Says.
Mostly
because we're coming off of a pretty fun episode with that, and it's terrible, but it's terrible in a lot of the right ways.
Well, that's my number four, is Simon Says, because look, you know me, I'm a D-Rod fan. I love D-Rod. I don't like Dane Cook.
I bet you do.
I'm a D-Rod fan.
I love D-Rod.
I love D-Rod. That is, the sex scene is just unbelievable in a way that scared me but enticed me at the same time. If anyone else is in that movie other than Dane Cook,
Robert Downey Jr.,
it makes the top five list for me.
Robert Downey Jr. Number four for me was Deadfall. I thought that movie was incredibly... incredibly boring. Michael Biehn is awful. The film noir twists were dumb. They kept going twist after twist. I was not enamored with Nicolas Cage's crackheadish kind of vibe or whatever. I thought it was just kind of, sorry. It's funny, as I'm looking at my list, I realized that Travolta, good 0% movies. Cage,
what?
Bad 0% movies.
Wow. Spoiler alert.
Zach, if you took the Cage performance out of Deadfall, how far does it drop?
Oh, it's down there. It's definitely in the bottom five.
Like, just like you said, if somebody else stepped in for Dane Cook, if somebody else stepped in for Nick Cage.
I think Simon Says it's top three for me if you put someone in instead of Dane Cook. Like, literally anybody. It could have been an avocado. And just...
How would an avocado do the...
My number four is Staying Alive. Yeah. You guessed it, Frank Stallone. The rest of it's very forgettable.
Yeah.
Was Frank Stallone ass off for us in the...
Oh, that's a good question. Man. I don't remember. It couldn't have been Travolta.
I don't even know who else would have been ass off, so...
I don't know who else is in the movie.
Ass off award. Frank Stallone as Carl.
Some dude named Charles Ward as Butler.
Wait, we gave Frank Stallone the ass off, not for the soundtrack, but for his actual acting.
Yeah, that's where that movie is. Travolta about the girl or whatever in that one scene, but probably just for singing the songs on stage.
I don't remember.
It was a live performance.
I don't remember at all. All right, number three for me. It was a holiday movie in the Harper House one year because I made everybody rent it and watch it. It is Left Behind, a Rapture movie. We have Major Bingo.
We've got Major Bingo.
We got Major Bingo. We've got Chad Michael Murray as this weird, like... we had that drug addict. We have Druggie people trying McHaroon to figure boobs. Out. Yeah, Druggie McHaroin boobs. Oh man, file.
Oh, on the plane.
And we had
the I won't make Maze supercharge it. But we had the guy that reminded us of our friend.
Oh.
the little person reminded us of our friend, and I'm not talking about Brad Williams.
All right.
Mine is of my friend who is not a little person. It's a good friend, though, man.
Good dude. Great person. Yeah.
That movie was made in 2014. It could have been 1998. There was no difference.
Oh, it could have been 1988. There was just...
Yeah.
Cliffhanger, too, you know?
Yeah, we're still waiting on Left Behind, too. Not really. I had Left Behind at number three as well.
Wow.
As that.
Okay.
Yeah, like, this is... The beginning of the zone where, you know, I've always held long that, like, along within cinephobe context, not throughout my life. Cinephobe taught me this, that believe it or not, even the worst movies follow a certain pattern that makes them a movie. Mm-hmm. And Left Behind is hanging on by a thread as far as following that pattern.
Yeah.
It's like just a little bit of a pattern, but it's so bad. Nicolas Cage is good in it. Everyone else was god awful.
So bad. Yeah.
I just remember a horny pastor. Was that in that?
Because when they were searching for the family, so it's not on the plane, but they're searching for the family, and he was like left in the church or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Left Behind was that. I'm looking at the Golden Dumpsters.
Remember when, just the kids' Major Bingo's clothes are just left like in the mall or something like that?
Yeah, he disappears and they just cut back to his clothes.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, Nicolas Cage's name was Captain Rayford Steele.
Mm-hmm.
And Major Bingo's name was Raimi Steele.
Rayford Steele should have made the names.
And somehow the Four Horsemen was film noir? How?
What was the film noir in that movie?
I don't remember.
Wow.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Maze. Yeah. Your number three
is problem child.
Wow.
What?
Little to no memory of this movie. Yes, Michael Richards threw a barbell, which Amin said was one of the best weapons in cinephobe history. It was him throwing this barbell.
Lots of barbell.
Dennis the Menace style pranks and hijinks. And yeah, they doctored the kid's hair on the poster. The kid wasn't really a ginger, but they tried to act like he was, and Amin disputed that.
Easy.
And then he pivoted to a baseless attack.
Well, got a lot of comments from you that give it some base.
Over the years, lots of base.
A lot more comments from you.
No trouble.
Super base. All right, number two for me, Teddy Rex. Theodore Rex is number two.
What could number one be?
I think, I mean, we did a rewatchington. It didn't help its case at all. I just don't really understand what the movie's about. I don't know why Whoopi's a robot. We have the problematic costume change montage, and then this. I mean, this motherfucker just never stops talking to himself. Annoying. Super annoying. But yeah, that's my number two.
My number two. Simon Says.
Wow.
I enjoyed making the episode. It was a fun episode to make.
But you're not a D-Rod fan.
I just, look, man, like I said, I subscribe to, like, there's got to be certain hallmarks of, if you're making a movie, it has to have things. The plot liftoff happened.
Hallmark one, don't have Dane Cook.
Yes. Hallmark two, plot liftoff cannot occur in the last 10 minutes of the movie.
It was like, all right, I'm going after the Eiffel Tower. It's like, what? Why?
Like, this whole time, he was doing all this shit because he wanted to blow shit up for money. But he's like, he already had money. So why would he, like, and who's also paying, like, hey, man, can you destroy, like, the Acropolis or whatever? Like, the Big Ben. Who's putting in requests like that and paying good money for it? It just, none of it made sense. And they didn't, it was almost zero exposition. Right? Remember, like, Dennis Rodman would just figure shit out.
He already knew it. As soon as they talked about it, he knew what the connection was.
Like, you guys remember, like, the Robert Downey Jr. Sherlock Holmes movies? And it's like, you know, something would have, like, someone is about to punch him. He's like, oh, the angle on the thing. And da da da. Over there, he sees it. Like, it's a whole breakdown of everything that's happening. It shows you how he whoops this guy's ass. This is the exact opposite. He would just, like, come to conclusions.
Just jump to the last part. Should we explain it? Nah. Let's just cut to the end. My number two is Left Behind. And my first note is Major Bingo. Because that's pretty much the predominant memory of this movie.
He wasn't in the movie that much, by the way. That's my favorite movie.
That's how bingo he was.
But there was one other thing about Left Behind that will make it a special cinephobe thing. It was the first movie on the Metalark Media Levitard show.
No.
That's our flashy debut.
And Zach chose this movie about the rapture.
I remember talking to Ben, and
he
Ben
was so,
like,
pissed.
Yeah, he was like, oh, that's what's up, man. All right, you guys doing Nicolas Cage? I was like, yeah, we're doing Nicolas. What movie are you doing? And I was like, oh, never mind. I'm like, what? It's like, Left Behind. He's like, what's Left Behind? He's like, well,
hey, I tried to explain it. Banger of an episode.
He was just, here we are a year later.
Introduce ourselves to a whole new audience with talking about a child actor named Major Bingo.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Oh my God.
Now the moment we've all been waiting for, Zach.
Yeah.
Number one, Problem Child. I fucking hate that movie. I hate it as a kid. I hate that kid. That kid is so annoying. Like, more annoying than Teddy Rex. That kid was, like, not funny, not interesting, not anything you would want to watch. I can't believe this kid got cast.
I can't believe this kid.
I did
That's
too.
How much I wanted to watch
fucking
it.
Terrible. Like, it's the worst movie
franchise.
Why'd
you watch the sequels?
Watch anything. That's pretty established at this point.
Yeah. We're about 200.
Especially me as a kid. I watched everything.
Barbed wire.
That was a different thing. But that was me discovering myself. But no, I fucking hate this movie. I never want to watch it again. Never. Not any of the other ones I would consider, like, all right, well, maybe a rewatch it and we could do this, whatever. No, fuck that movie. I hate Problem Child.
I spent some time trying to remember if Gilbert Gottfried played Abraham Lincoln in that movie, but no, it was a different. He was in it. He was the head of the orphanage.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
He played Abraham Lincoln in A Million Ways to Die in the West.
It's to Die in the West, yeah.
Isn't John Ritter in Problem Child?
Yeah, he's the dad.
He
How
is.
Do you make
he's...
a John Ritter movie bad? John Ritter's fucking didn't. Hilarious.
He did. Made it great. He was super like nice and...
Super bingo.
And no. John Ritter?
No, the kid.
Oh, okay. Shit. I was going to say John Ritter killed him in that movie. Dead. So did... what's his name? The played John Ritter's dad. Fuck, man. I forget his name. But he always plays the same gruff asshole every fucking movie.
Robert Loggia?
No.
Robert Loggia. No, is that Robert Loggia? No, it wasn't Robert Loggia.
I know who you're talking about, I mean.
Yeah. He's like a fake Robert Loggia.
You like the movie so much, you have no idea who's in it. What's your number one?
My number one is Teddy Rexman. Like, this isn't a movie. And this is the movie that taught me, like, the bare minimums to be a movie. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, okay, now I get it. Like, I thought,
single-handedly... ended. It started and ended fan suggestions for movies
forever.
We do. That's how bad it was.
If you've ever wondered why, like, we're not looking, this comes from like Pete and Saint, Saint Paul or whatever. We don't do it because we did it one time. It was Teddy Rex, and we were gonna make it a regular thing. Yeah,
we were gonna make it a regular thing.
The end of the month.
Yeah,
the fourth movie of the month was gonna be what the people wanted,
and that ended it.
Ike the Terrorist, as his, I don't even know what Ike's last name is. I just know we call him Ike the Terrorist.
Yeah. It was so,
it didn't, when I say it didn't make sense, it was Jack Warden, by the way, the guy I was thinking about.
Oh,
Jack Warden.
Yeah.
But like when I say it didn't make sense, there was no plot, there was no story, there was no plot lift off. It was just random things. Hey, we're going to bring dinosaurs back from the dead. Also, they're going to be sentient. And also, they're going to have like regular jobs. And they're going to wear clothes. And also, Whoopi's a robot. Also, there's someone who's out here to want to get everybody in. Also, this dude loves cookies. He's horny for cookies. But also, he wants to bang the wife of a murdered dinosaur at the funeral. Mm-hmm. And also she's down for it. And all mm-hmm. like, it was just like, there was no rhyme or reason to any of it. It was god awful.
Mace?
Well, we do need to do a Gaudy Rewatchington just so I can remind myself how bad this movie is. Want to talk about a timeline being fucked up? This movie jumped all over the place with no context. Do you remember the name of the actor who played his son? Spencer Rocco LaFranco.
Yeah. Oh.
There's a Pitbull soundtrack.
Well, hold on.
Exactly. Exactly. Pitbull's in that fucking movie.
Does that sound like John Gotti music?
Wait. Everything is, in the words of Dan Levitard, everything's moving too fast. Slow down. Everyone slow down. How did we not have him in the top five names list?
That's a good question.
It's not a fictional name. It's his real name.
No. Oh, we're not allowed to do real names?
It was fictional names. We were doing like characters and stuff.
I did Nick Kurt Dale. Yeah, well,
we're not going to talk about your list. All right. You did a website and a product.
Say it again.
So you're all over the place.
Nick Kurt Dale.com.
Don't worry. Everyone listening two times.
Don't listen on two speed. Don't do it.
Oh, there's a lot of people listening. Don't do it.
Wow. Gotti number one. That's bullshit.
The behind the scenes from our guy Sammy the Bull telling us about how E would walk away from set to make phone calls to secure more funding so they could keep making this awful movie. And the G-force, the sheer magnitude of going from
hamster movie.
This movie to the Fanatic of John Gotti. Of Travolta playing John Gotti to playing Moose still blows my mind.
Like, you phobed that one too, right?
I phobed them both. Yeah, you guys.
What?
That was a terrible time for me. I hated both of you guys after picking those movies back to back.
What are you talking about?
By the way, speaking of Gotti, that's who Floyd Mayweather fought. This weekend with the brawl happened.
That was John Gotti the third.
Oh my God.
John Gotti the third.
I thought I saw all these clips on like TikTok and shit. I'm like, oh, what is this old fight? Why are they bringing up this old fight?
Mayweather
and all that shit was this weekend?
That just happened. Yeah.
Whoa.
I mean, I don't know where we are in the timeline. When does this come out?
Today.
Oh, okay. All right. Cool. Wow.
We went through this 50 minutes ago.
Wow.
It's tough to say when it comes out.
The timeline, though. It's all fucked up. 50 minutes ago or is it 3 weeks ago? I don't know.
That's a good question. Make sure you're giving us your top 5 0% movies, your 2 OLIs, and then your bottom 5 0% movies at Talk Hoops, at Darth Amin, at Corn Puzzle, at Count the Dings, or patreon.com/countthedings. Get in that Cinephobe Discord channel. Throw it in there. How about that?
I hear Reddit is going to go down at some point this week.
What do you mean?
I gleaned from like other Reddit forums that something big is about to happen at Reddit where it's about to get shut down.
Good.
So like if you're in the Cinephobe Reddit, maybe check out the Discord. Mm. You know, there's some great like-minded conversation going on over there. And that's it. That's how you guys want to end it.
Bye.
Jesus Christ.
Next time we make love, you introduce me to Jade.